Welcome to worship. It's a delight to see each and every one of you this morning. And of course, we have some special guests, right?
Great.
It's all about baby Charlotte. Well, before we get to the fun stuff, we do have some announcements to make. And the Crystal Bridges fellowship event was canceled last week due to weather, so they are going to reschedule for the 31st. We have Palm Sunday starting next week, kicking off Holy Week, so be here with us. The Easter extravaganza is going to be a little different this year at the request of the Happy Campers. We're going to have an event for them Friday in the afternoon. There is a typo in the bulletin. We're not going to have it at 2:30 in the morning, although it would be a little easier to hide the eggs, just saying. We do need some help with that. You can check out the information and see what to do. There is a whole lot of stuff in the bulletin. Take it home, read it, and volunteer for the events that are listed there. And now I'd like to extend a special greeting to those who are watching us online. May the grace and peace of Jesus be with you. And now let's bow in prayer, please. Precious and Holy Father, we ask that you center us this morning, that you open our hearts and open our minds to what you would have us learn today, that we would be a people of celebration, a people who demonstrate love and justice, that we would be a shining example in our community through John Knox Presbyterian Church, that we would be a people of joy, joy in Christ, joy in community, and a joy in the world. We ask these things in the name of Jesus. Amen. And now I'd like to have Kate and Sean and baby Charlotte come up and give a little testimony of what's been happening in their lives. Pretty exciting. Let's give a thank offering to the Lord. You could give me the baby. Just kidding.
Oh yeah, I'm not tall enough. Hold on. Let me get the Zacchaeus step up here. Thank you. There we are.
Hello everybody.
This is Charlotte. It's hard to believe we've been gone from John Knox a little over a year and a half. I completed a one-year contract as interim minister at First Presbyterian Church in Lee's Summit. I learned a lot about being a head of staff and the importance of a good transitional person. And I enjoyed the interim work, but it was almost as difficult as having a baby. We were only in Lee Summit a couple of months when we found out we were expecting baby Charlotte, and we are so grateful for your prayers throughout my pregnancy, and she was so small and is still small, but she's 7 months old and growing and thriving, and we're very grateful for her. She's almost perfect, but we're biased, so. And then our next adventure is on April 5th. We board a plane and head to Hawaii, where I have accepted a call at Christ Church Uniting Presbyterians and Disciples. Long name, but it's a small progressive congregation that is Disciples of Christ and Presbyterian. So it's ecumenical, it's welcoming of LGBT folks, they care about earth care and mission and all of the things that we care about. So it's on the island of Oahu, and we look forward to our next grand adventure. But we are so glad to be here with you all, and we celebrate the time that we were in ministry together. We have so much love for you, so we're so glad to be here.
Thank you.
can move the box back in because I'm tall enough. Please join me in the call to worship and we'll responsively do this. Rejoice, proclaim God's holy presence.
Let our voices be raised in joy. God is with us.
Our Savior Jesus is with us, offering us lessons in living and serving. Give us lives of loving service to others.
Open our ears and our hearts to hear his words of encouragement.
Lift our voices in joyful praise. And the hymn is 464. If you'd like to see the music.
Was broken forevermore. How deep, how wide, how intimate and close to us is the love, the mercy, and the forgiveness of God.
Hear the call to confession as we pray together. Lord, you have breathed into us your creative, joyful spirit. You have lifted us from the dust into the joy of your presence. We are so grateful for all that you have done for us. Each day reminds us of the many things of your mercy and your love. Yet there are times when we have been hurt and frightened and wondered where we were. Forgive us. Remind us again of your loving presence. Comfort us when we become afraid, lost, lonely, and fearful. Prepare us to serve you faithfully all of our days. And now your own silent prayers. And now join me in the ending, for it is in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Hear Christ's words of grace to us. Our sins are forgiven. We believe in the forgiveness of sins. We are saved by God's grace through faith in Jesus Christ. As we resolve to follow the path that Jesus walked, let us offer one another the sustaining power of Christ's peace. May the peace of Christ be with you.
And also with you.
If you would all please be seated. And let's go to the Lord in prayer. Please bow with me. Holy Spirit, we ask that you would send your wisdom throughout our sanctuary and throughout the homes and places where those are listening online. Open our hearts, open our minds so that we may hear your word spoken, so we may hear your word, internalize it, and become doers of your word. Father, don't leave us as mere hearers, but have us to be active and passionate in pursuit of the things that you would have us do in and through this church. We ask these things in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Light the fire, wait. youngest citizens to come forward. And you can even use a lot of bouncing because the piece that she just did was so overwhelming. Gaius, are you coming? Hi. All right, we're going to try doing this, okay? I'm going to sit down. And Dad may have to help me get up, okay? Oh, very good. All right.
I'm going to put my shoes. I'm going to have to put shoes on my knees so I can be
real. Gaius, are you coming over here to join us? Why don't you come right over here? Is that for me? No? So, you know what? Let's take an example. When it's your birthday and you get some birthday presents.
You're invited.
Thank you. But when you have a birthday, the whole church can come. Well, listen, when we have, for example, a birthday or it's Christmas and we experience a lot of joy on our birthday, don't we? Well, one of the things that is so important when we are learning about Jesus and God is how much joy we can have just by being present. So, keeping joy in mind, let's say a little prayer, okay? Dear God, fill our hearts with love and joy. Help us to learn you and to know you, and help us to share joy with everyone that we see. Amen. All right.
Testament reading is from Luke 15, 21 through 24. Short verses, familiar verses. Let's read them together in unison. The son said to him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and against you. I am no longer worthy to be called your son. But the father said to his servants, Quick, bring the best robe and put it on him. Put on the ring on his finger and sandals on his feet. Bring the fatted calf and kill it. Let's have a feast and celebrate. For this son of mine was dead and is alive now again. He was lost and is found. So they began to celebrate. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our Old Testament scripture for this morning is taken from Psalm 150. Praise the Lord. Praise God in his sanctuary. Praise him in his mighty heavens. Praise him for his acts of power. Praise him for his surpassing greatness. Praise him with the sounding of the trumpet. Praise him with the harp and the lyre. Praise him with the timbrel and dancing. Praise him with the strings and pipe. Praise him with the clash of cymbals. Praise him with resounding cymbals. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Did you know that there is a World Happiness Index? Yes, it's true. And every year, the World Happiness Index surveys people from around the world to find the countries that have the happiest populations. They talk about GDP and life expectancy and generosity and social support and lack of corruption and freedom. Does anybody know who the 2022 winner is? Totally ruining my surprise. Yes, it's Finland. And this is the sixth year in a row that Finland has won. Does anybody, except for the front row, does anybody know what the United States is ranked? Yeah, not even in the top 10. 15th. Yikes. So what gives some people the special ability to be happy, to be joyful? For those of us who follow Jesus, the answer is found in Scripture and let loose in the spiritual discipline of celebration. We are continuing our series on the spiritual disciplines. The spiritual disciplines help us replace our old destructive habits with life-giving ones. Remember, the spiritual disciplines can't do anything in of themselves. They only put us before the Lord so that the Holy Spirit can do the work of transformation. And in them, we will live more freely and fully in the presence of God, because we serve a God of joy. The Westminster Shorter Catechism tells us that our chief end is to glorify God and to enjoy him forever. Joy is our eternal destiny, but we don't always act like joyful people. I have a favorite author, and he uses humor, and I thought this is funny, so I'm going to give it a sad try to be humorous. So he writes, "Just for a moment, imagine how the opening sentences of the Bible might read if God were not a supremely joyful being." So here goes. In the beginning, it was 9 o'clock. So God had to go to work. He filled out a requisition form to separate the light from the darkness. He considered making the stars to beautify the night and planets to fill the skies, but it sounded like too much work. And besides, he thought, that's really not my job. So he decided to knock off early and call it a day. And he looked at what he had done and said, yeah, it'll have to do. God made a pigeon to fly, and a carp for the waters, and a cat to creep on the dry land. God thought about making millions of other species of all sizes and shapes and colors, but could not drum up the enthusiasm. In fact, he wasn't too crazy about the cat. Sorry, cat people. And it was almost time for the late show. At the end of the week, God was seriously burned out. So he breathed a big sigh of relief and said, "Thank me, it's Friday." Okay, that was good. Thank me, it's Friday. Okay, so can I get an amen for getting
amen.
Through this?
Amen.
Yes, thank you. So here's the deal. Imagine if God approached his work in life as we so often do, with very little joy, very little happiness, and very little enthusiasm. It's important to God that we learn to celebrate his provision and his goodness. I don't often quote from Leviticus, but here goes. Leviticus 23:2 says, "Speak to the Israelites and say to them, 'These are my appointed festivals, the appointed festivals of the Lord, which you are to proclaim as sacred assemblies.'" Festivals are celebrations. Something happens when we gather in community that cannot happen in solitude. We are not created to be lone rangers. C.S. Lewis said, "Joy is the serious business of heaven." Jesus entered our world on a note of celebration. Luke 2:10-11 tells us, "But the angel said to them, 'Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all people. For to you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord.'" Jesus came into the world bringing joy, and he left the world telling his disciples to be joyful. John 15:11. "I have said these things to you so that my joy may be in you and your joy may be complete." We are to be a people full of joy. Life without joy can be very miserable. And what is even more disappointing is where people who are far from God look at us, look at Christians, and assign to God our grim and judgmental and defensive spirits. Joy is strength. In its absence, weakness. Dallas Willard says, "Failure to obtain a deeply satisfying life always has the effect of making sinful actions seem good. Here lies the strength of temptation. Normally, our success in overcoming temptation will be easier if we are basically happy in our lives. Joy in the Lord is what brings us the strength. How can we not have joy when we have a God who loves us, promises to forgive us, promises to be with us, wants to bless us forever in eternity, is Emmanuel God with us? So we have to choose joy. Joy is your responsibility. It's not your friends, it's not your spouses or your parents or your kids or your boss. Joy is your responsibility. Please don't live with the illusion that someday, whenever that someday comes for you, then suddenly you will have joy. If you wait for that Sunday, someday, sometime, somehow, it'll never happen. Joy does not simply happen to us, writes spiritual author Henry Nouwen. We have to choose joy and keep choosing joy every day. Because joy takes practice. Remember, our spiritual life isn't about trying really, really hard. It's about developing healthy spiritual habits through practice and discipline. So how do you practice the discipline of celebration? Somebody just said it over here. Celebrate. This one was not rocket science. Gathering with people you love. One day a week, only one day. Eat the foods you love. Yesterday in my life was an excellent example of that. Just saying. Play a sport that stretches and challenges you. How many years have you been playing soccer, Bob? Read a book. Surround yourself with beauty. Sing, dance. How fun was it to have the Hogue family with us this morning, right?
Right.
Right? And yes, you can see them after the worship service. Spiritual celebration means that while you're celebrating, you take the time to reflect on what an amazing God we have. The one who gave us a reason to celebrate, the gifts and all the things that we have to celebrate. In our celebration, we have the ability to see and to feel God's goodness. Nothing is too small if it produces joy in us and causes us to turn to God with gratitude and delight. Music is one of the best ways to relieve a bad mood. If you're having a bad day, turn on a positive song, sing along, sing in the shower, sing wherever you are in the car, play your favorite tunes. Hang out with happy people. Proverbs 15:30 tells us, a friendly smile makes you happy and good news makes you feel strong. Happy people breathe life into us. Prize them, because there are people who do reject joy. There will always be joy killers in life, but we need to love them as best we can, but be careful not to let them shape you or shape your attitudes. Be around happy people. Obedience to Christ produces genuine joy. Like the old hymn tells us, there is no other way to be happy in Jesus but to... Oh my gosh. So Kate and Sean are here today. This is an old hymn, not a praise song. Trust and obey? Yes. But here's a hard saying from Richard Foster. Some people live in such a way that it's impossible to have any kind of happiness in their home. And then when they go to church and sing songs and pray in the Spirit, they hope that somehow God will give them an infusion of joy to make it through the day. They look at that infusion of joy to somehow bypass the misery of their daily lives. But it doesn't work that way, because we are all part of the sanctification process. God loves us where we are, but God does not intend us to stay where we are. We are to grow and change and move into the image of Christ. And obedience means giving up any sin that we may be clinging to, whether that's anger or bitterness or an addiction. Because God's desire is to transform our misery into joy, not simply bypass it. Practice celebration by making family events special. I don't think it's a coincidence that weddings figure prominently in God's great story. Celebrate worship, celebrate weddings, birthdays, look back on things with gratitude, look forward in hope. Celebrate finishing a major project, or securing a job, or getting a raise, or simply the beauty of the day. And do not dwell on the negative. Dorothy Greco writes, our memories tend to be short-term. We get so easily distracted and swallowed up by both the incidental and the enormous challenges in life that we forget the many times that God has dropped manna or parted the waters for us. When the bank account dips below minimum, or the mechanic's bill exceeds our weekly paycheck, or the pathology report comes back positive, It feels more natural to shake our fists at God rather than to organize a party. That's why celebrations are so crucial in our spiritual life, because the very act of celebrating anchors us in the deeper story. And the deeper story is about Jesus and how God created us, wonderfully made, forming us from the dust and calling us into a loving relationship with Him, one that has eternity, eternity full of joy. And so Philippians 4:8 tells us, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about those things. Think about the positive things that are happening in your life. So how do we find joy when things are difficult? Following Jesus Christ does not make us immune to problems. Nowhere in Scripture does it say that this is the easy way. We all have problems. But there's a story that I think puts it into context. Dietrich Bonhoeffer, the great theologian, was in a concentration camp in Flossenbürg. We live a very different life here in America, and we have some difficulty understanding what it would be like to be in a concentration camp. But here's what his fellow inmates and prisoners said about Dietrich Bonhoeffer. Bonhoeffer always seemed to me to spread an atmosphere of happiness and joy over the least incident and profound gratitude for the mere fact that he is alive. How many of us have that resilience and take for granted the privileges that we have? Because life is a gift. We don't earn it, we don't control it. It is a gift from God, every tick of the clock. Scripture doesn't call us to celebrate tragedies, but it does ask us to be a thankful people because we belong to the Lord. Augustine of Hippo says, the Christian should be an alleluia from head to toe. Throughout Scripture, there are many promises of joy. Psalm 16:11, you make known to me the path of life. You fill me with joy in your presence, with eternal pleasures at your right hand. Isaiah 35:10, and those the Lord has rescued will return. They will enter Zion singing. Everlasting joy will crown their heads. Gladness and joy will overtake them, and sorrow and sighing will be far away. John 16:24, until now you have not asked for anything in my name. Ask and you will receive, and your joy will be complete. Romans 14:17, for the kingdom of God is not a matter of eating and drinking, but of righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Spirit. Nehemiah 8:10, go and enjoy choice food and sweet drinks, and send some of those who have nothing prepared. This day is holy to our Lord. Do not grieve, for the joy of the Lord is your strength. Without a joyful spirit, without being a joyful presence around people, life is pretty dull. So take the time to have many celebrations, big celebrations, medium-sized celebrations. Purposely practice the celebration of discipline. Wear what you like to wear, eat what you like to eat, music, listen to music that you like to hear, sing music you like to sing, but be with people who fill you with joy, and in obedience to Christ, celebrate.
Please rise as we have our affirmation of faith. It comes from the Westminster Shorter Catechism. What is the chief end of man? Man's chief end is to glorify God and enjoy Him forever.
Please be seated. It is a privilege to be together, to be gathered in community where we can pray with and for one another. I encourage you to take the bulletin home with you and pray for the names that are listed in the bulletin throughout the week. There is nothing more powerful than prayer. Please bow with me. Almighty God, we know that your heart is broken by the sins of the world. We see prejudice, hatred, and war, and we pray that you would bring your peace to the Ukraine, to parts of Africa. Wherever there is hatred, bring peace. We know, Lord, that in your world there are people who starve, and so we pray that you would bring food. We pray for, Lord, for those who are trafficked and enslaved, we pray that you would bring freedom and justice. We lift up to you all the missionaries across denominational lines that are in the darkest of places. We pray that your light would shine, that they would be renewed and refreshed, that they would be winsome. Father, we lift up to you our own country. We pray for our president, Congress, the judicial branch, the men and women who serve on every level. We ask that you would give them wisdom and discernment. We pray, Lord, for all the many families that were affected by the tornadoes that went through Mississippi. We pray in particular for those who lost loved ones. We ask that you would send your Holy Spirit to bring them peace in Christ through this grieving process. We pray, Lord, that you would bring people to help people rebuild their homes and their shattered lives. We ask that you would be in the midst of all the weather events that have swept across our country, from snows to flooding. Lord, we pray that you would help the homeless find shelter. We pray for our community of Tulsa and the surrounding area. We ask, Lord, that you would be with us, that you would be with the lost, the alone, the marginalized, and the addicted, that you would bring freedom. We are so thankful, Lord, for the gift of Kate and her ministry and her precious family. So we ask, Lord, that you would bless them mightily in this new call in Hawaii, that you would grow Charlotte strong in her faith, that you would help Sean and Kate have wisdom and discernment in their new church, in their new call, and in their new mission. We lift up to you now in this moment of silence, Lord, the things that are on our own heart, those that bring us joy or give us cause for concern. Father, we lift up to you the concerns in our own congregation, and we ask that you would be with Norman Pop, who is in the hospital. We ask you to be with Terry, who is in the hospital, to be with Barbara and Wally and Marty and Joan, Irene and Catherine, Betty and Carol, Joanne and Bruce, Betty Lou and Ed. Lord, we ask that you would be bringing healing to them in the name of Jesus Christ, healing from disease and surgery. We pray that you would be with their caregivers, their doctors, all those who are helping them, giving them wisdom and insight and comfort. Renew especially, Lord, the caregivers. Father, we ask that you would be with our sister church in Malawi, that you would bring medicine to those who have been affected by the outbreak of cholera, that you would be with those who have been impacted by the cyclone. Father, we pray for our sister church that they may minister in your name wisely, that they may be a light in their country. And now, Lord, we ask that we would continue to honor you by being a joyful people. So help us to instill the habit, Lord. Help us to choose joy. Help us to be a winsome people for those who are lost and alone. And now we pray, Lord, the way that Jesus taught his friends, the disciples, to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Now is the time for the giving of our tithes and offerings. If you are visiting with us today, please don't feel obligated to give. Let this worship service be our gift to you. Almighty God, we thank you for the gift of your Son, Jesus, the Messiah. In his life, his death, and most importantly, his resurrection, you have given us so much. We have forgiveness and love. We have joy and peace and eternal life. For all these things and so much more, Lord, we are grateful. And so we give you our gifts. We ask that you would bless them, that you would multiply them, that you would help us use them according to your will and your purposes through John Knox Presbyterian Church. Amen. loves you, that Jesus Christ died and rose again for you, that the Holy Spirit dwells in you now and forevermore, and be a people of joy. And God's people say, Amen. Amen.